This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Story: A Nightmare. Kunin, a young man of 30, who was a permanent member of the rural board, on returning from Petersburg to his district Borisovo, immediately sent a mounted messenger to Sinkino for the priest there, Father Yakov Smirnov. 5 hours later, Father Yakov appeared. "Very glad to make your acquaintance," said Kunin, meeting him in the entry. "I've been living and serving here for a year. It seems as though we ought to have been acquainted before."
"You are very welcome.
But how young you are," Kunin added in surprise.
"What is your age?"
28, said Father Yakov, faintly pressing Kunin's outstretched hand and for some reason turning crimson. Kunin led his visitor into his study and began looking at him more attentively. "What an uncouth womanish face," he thought. There certainly was a good deal that was womanish in Father Yakov's face: the turned-up nose, the bright red cheeks, and the large gray-blue eyes with scanty, scarcely perceptible eyebrows. His long reddish hair, smooth and dry, hung down in straight tails onto his shoulders. The hair on his upper lip was only just beginning to form into a real masculine mustache, while his little beard belonged to that class of good-for-nothing beards which among divinity students are for some reason called ticklers. It was scanty and extremely transparent. It could not have been stroked or combed. It could only have been pinched. All these scanty decorations were put on unevenly in tufts, as though Father Yakov, thinking to dress up as a priest and beginning to gum on the beard, had been interrupted halfway through. He had on a cassock, the color of weak coffee with chicory in it, with big patches on both elbows. "A queer type," thought Kunin, looking at his muddy skirts. "Comes to the house for the first time, and can't dress decently." "Sit down, Father," he began more carelessly than cordially, as he moved an easy chair to the table. "Sit down, I beg you." Father Yakov coughed into his fist, sank awkwardly onto the edge of the chair, and laid his open hands on his knees. With his short figure, his narrow chest, his red and perspiring face, he made from the first moment a most unpleasant impression on Kunin. The latter could never have imagined that there were such undignified and pitiful-looking priests in Russia, and in Father Yakov's attitude, in the way he held his hands on his knees and sat on the very edge of his chair, he saw a lack of dignity and even a shade of servility.
"I have invited you on business, Father," Kunin began, sinking back in his low chair. "It has fallen to my lot to perform the agreeable duty of helping you in one of your useful undertakings. On coming back from Petersburg, I found on my table a letter from the Marshal of Nobility. Igor Dmitrievich suggests that I should take under my supervision the church parish school, which is being opened in Sinkino. I shall be very glad to, Father."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.